Hello everyone, this is group 12 and I am Ashwin Agrawal, one of the generators of this group. Anyone who has ever worked in an open plan office will be aware of the fact that how drastically different people's individual temperature preferences are. This is one of the reasons why thermostat is arguably the biggest source of conflict in offices around the world. We can consider our example only. In IITB, the outside temperature is such that we can go out just by wearing a cotton shirt. But as we enter our lecture halls, there is drastic temperature change. Some students ask to turn off fans and ACs because they are feeling cold, while others are perfectly fine with their temperature. You must also have experienced that when we go out of an air-conditioned room, there is drastic change in temperature. And this also causes a lot of health issues. Wouldn't it be amazing if there was a clothing that could more easily adapt to the temperature requirements of a person by doing some heat transfer processes inside it? So we have tried to study and analyze the heat transfer between human body and clothing and to observe the changes in temperature and heat flow by changing different conditions. So this is our approach. Firstly, we will study the heat flow between the human body and clothes with surroundings, studying different mechanisms by which there is heat exchanges possible, then study various fabrics and to differentiate them on the basis of their different properties. And the eventual goal is to design such a clothing which shows minimum variation in temperature with temperature changes in surroundings. Now, first of all, designing such a thing requires thorough study of all the mechanism of heat transfer, heat exchanges going on in the human body and clothes. So this is the geometry of the human body in the left, showing different heat transfer modes. And in the right, if we zoom in at any area of the cloth, it looks like this. There is an air gap between skin and cloth in which most of the heat transfer occurs. This is a very broad overview of the geometry on which we are going to work. We will come to more detailed control volumes in the later slides. So we are going to assume our control volume as a human arm in horizontal position. Heat transfer in human body is very complicated. It varies with different parts of the body. So for simplification, we are going to apply computational fluid dynamics approach to perform 2D transient simulations of flow and heat transfer around a closed human limb in horizontal position. Our configuration consists of a 2D horizontal impermeable cylinder, which is limb. We are assuming it to be perfect cylinder of variable diameter. The horizontal cylinder configuration can be seen to represent the microclimates around some regions of the body, for example, arms or thighs, when seated or rectilinear positions. We are assuming forced convection in a colder environment having an ambient temperature of 10 degrees Celsius and assuming the skin temperature as 36 degrees Celsius. Moreover, we are assuming inlet air velocity to be 0.54 meter per second, which is approximately 2 km per hour, which is representative of situations with little wind or indoor activities. Now, coming to detailed control volume. Our control volume looks like this. We can clearly see the boundary condition for flow and different properties of control volume. Here, D limb is the diameter of the limb. U inlet is the velocity by which air is coming inside the cloth. DEXT is the diameter of the limb plus cloth system. And we have divided our control volume into 5 regions, 1 to 5. All the regions are clearly visible and stated. Now coming to the technical problem statement. This is a textbook problem. A person is sitting on the table in a room wearing full sleeves garment. The temperature in the room is 10 degrees Celsius and the resting skin is 36 degrees Celsius. Study the changes in the temperature of the body on varying different parameters of the clothes and find how the body temperature and heat flow is affected when external properties are changed. And obviously, we will have to take a lot more assumptions to solve this problem. Now coming to heat transfer modes. For this, we will firstly need to understand how heat flow in human body works. So human body converts the energy provided by food into work and heat, depending mainly on the level of activity. For example, when doing office work, the human body has some metabolic rate. To keep the body temperature at a constant level, heat is released by evaporation, radiation, convection, and conduction. There are two convections, from skin to cloth and from cloth to surrounding air. There is conduction in the cloth material and radiation from the surroundings to the cloth, and there is heat transfer by evaporation. We will look into these one by one in the following slides. So coming to convection. Convection is taking place between skin and cloth. We know that heat transfer by convection is HA into temperature of the skin minus temperature of the cloth. Here, HSCL is the convective heat transfer coefficient, which in this case depend on insulation of the air layer and effective insulation of the cloth material. However, insulation of the clothing and additional layer of air are influenced by air velocity as well as human movement. Second is evaporation. The amount of heat being released from the skin is influenced by two issues. Firstly, it depends on the body's heat balance. Only under warm ambient conditions or high exercise levels will significant sweating occur. Second is the environment's vapor pressure. Here, we are going to neglect the excess sweat because there is no physical movement. The heat due to evaporation will be HE into AA multiplied by the difference between the saturated vapor pressure on the skin surface and the partial vapor pressure of the trapped air inside clothing. Here, HE is the evaporative heat transfer coefficient and can be calculated by this relation given here. Here, LR is Lewis relation, which simply describes the relationship between convective heat transfer and mass transfer coefficient and equal to 16.5 Kelvin per kilopascal at typical indoor conditions. Convection 2 is the heat exchange between the surface of the clothing and environment. This can be simply calculated as HC into area into difference between the surface temperature of the clothing and environment. Here, HC is the convective heat transfer coefficient, which depends on the air velocity. Now, the next heat transfer mode is evaporation, partial vapor pressure of clothing in the environment. When moisture is transferred from skin to clothing, the humidity in the tissue increases. The water is absorbed in the clothing, which is given by MABS, where HPAP is the heat of vaporization of water. And due to absorption process, heat capacity is modified by the relation given here for CCL. And this sweat also vaporizes into the environment. But since we are assuming negligible sweat, M of H2O, which is mass of H2O, can be neglected. Now the radiation is taking place between walls and cloth, so which can be given by this known formula. And solar radiation will be zero because we are assuming that the room is closed. And finally, conduction in the layer of cloth, which can be calculated by minus K dT by dx. Now, study of all the possible heat transfer modes is done, and after substituting the values of all the constants in the assumption and the assumptions, we get these numerical values for all the modes. Convective heat transfer between skin and cloth comes out to be 89 watt per meter. We are neglecting evaporation since we are assuming negligible sweat coming out of the body of the person. Since the temperature inside the room is cold, the convective transfer heat transfer between the outer layer of the cloth and surroundings is 98.9 watt per meter. The radiation heat transfer is coming out to be 136 watt per meter, and the dominant mode is conduction. We are assuming cotton as our fabric for which thermal conductivity is 0.045, and by this assumption, we are getting convective heat transfer as 2.0 profile. This figure shown here is the temperature profile for our problem statement. Although this is self-explanatory, but I will go through some important points. The vertical axis is the temperature axis. Horizontal axis here is the distance from the skin and is going away from the skin as we are going towards right. The red curve shown is convection between skin and cloth. Green one is conduction in fabric layer, and the blue one is the convection from cloth to surroundings. Now coming to the important equations and relations required for the analysis. The first and the most important is Reynolds number. After substituting the density and viscosity of air at 10 degrees Celsius, U inlet as 0.54 and diameter of limb plus cloth system as 0.11 meter, we get the Reynolds number as 3900. And the characteristic length is defined as the coefficient between microclimate thickness or the air gap thickness, which is H gap, and the clothing characteristic dimension, which is DEXT. So our main focus is going to study the effect of characteristic length, or we can also say microclimate thickness ratio or heat transfer around the limb. We are going to perform simulations for three different values of IG, 0.05, 0.10, and 0.25, which are representing the range often found in clothing. This is achieved by keeping the external diameter constant at 0.11 meter and decreasing the diameter of the limb from 0.10 meter, which corresponds to IG equal to 0.05, to 0.09 meter, for which IG is 0.10, and 0.06 meter, which corresponds to IG equal to 0.25. By doing this, we can maintain the Reynolds number at 3900, thereby maintaining the properties of the airflow around the cloth limb constant. Now coming to NU correlation, the convective heat transfer coefficient for surfaces facing the clothing enclosure is expressed as NU into K air divided by delta. The magnitude of Rayleigh number is the property that determines how heat is transferred throughout a fluid. The Rayleigh number is the product of Grashof and Prandtl number, where GR can be expressed as the equation shown. And for different Rayleigh number, we can see different correlation for Nusselt number. And on the right, we can see the same for external surface in comparison to the left, which shows for inner microclimate within the skin of the fabric. Now, to perform computational fluid dynamics, we have to solve the incompressible Navier-Stokes equation of continuity, momentum, and energy. In the momentum equation, the term Ui Uj bar corresponds to the Reynolds stresses and represents the effects of the turbulent eddies. And these are the equations of Navier-Stokes equations, which are given on the right. Now coming to CFD analysis, we modeled the effect using a LRN turbulence model and K epsilon turbulence model. We used a hybrid mesh containing both triangular and quadrilateral elements featuring approximately 40,000 elements. Smaller elements were placed where the vortex shedding occurs near the skin and fabric boundaries as required by the model. However, we made sure that mass imbalances are below 0.1% and energy imbalances are below 1% in the microclimate. This is the analysis we obtained. Here, on observing this result, we can see that for the lowest Ig, which was 0.05, the fluent temperature patterns seem symmetrical relative to the cross section separating upper and lower portions of the microclimate. When Ig is higher, which is 0.25, the fluent temperature patterns become asymmetrical because of the onset of natural convection inside the microclimate. Two counter-rotating convection cells form within the microclimate, one at either side of the limb for Ig equal to 0.25. On both the cells, ascending flow occurs near the warmer region, which is skin, and descending flow near the colder region, which is fabric. Now, these are the results we obtained after analyzing the model. We observed that for Ig above the critical value of 0.10, the temperature field and heat fluxes in the microclimate change dramatically because of the increasing importance of natural convection. The temperature of the fabric outer surface was observed to vary by as much as 9 Kelvin when Ig is increased from 0.05 to 0.25, and convective and radiative heat fluxes at the skin by up to 190% and 80% respectively. For Ig of 0.05 and 0.25, the temperature along the outer fabric varies by 14 Kelvin and 9 Kelvin respectively, and convective fluxes along the skin vary up to by 70% and 90%, and radiative fluxes by about 80% and 60% respectively. So we have done the detailed analysis of heat transfer and temperature changes on changing the characteristic length. This knowledge on the flow and temperature patterns occurring in cylindrical clothing microclimates is of key importance when designing protective clothing, as they can considerably affect the transport rates from the body, especially if the condition of use allow for natural convection to set in. We know that our goal was to design such a clothing, but designing such a complicated system was very cumbersome. We tried to study the heat flow in space suits, which regulates the temperature through pipes flow, but bringing that to day-to-day life is not economical, and its design is very complicated to study for us. So instead, we tried to study and analyze the heat flow instead of designing such a system and draw important results from them. Though it is for sure a possibility in future to design some mechanism like in space suits to regulate body temperature in an efficient way. Thank you for your time. I hope you liked our project. Thank you.